Hi, and welcome back to the third part of the control panel function tutorial using the Siemens S7-1200 PLC. In this video, we will add a light to the factory I/O control panel, then program the PLC utilising its 2 Hz internal clock to flash the light on and off as soon as the emergency stop is activated, so stay tuned. Okay, let's put the system in auto and press the start button to get the system running and explain what we're going to do. Okay, let's get some pallets coming down and then I'll press the emergency stop. What you can see on the control panel is the green start light goes out and the red stop light comes on. But this red stop light is the same light that comes on when the stop button is pressed. So as it stands, there is no way of telling if the emergency stop was pressed or just the stop button. Therefore, to distinguish between them, we will add another red light to the control panel that flashes when the emergency stop button is pressed. So let's stop factory I/O and we'll scroll down the list of available items to search for a red panel light. There we go. Let's drag it onto the scene and then let it go. Now the light is facing in the wrong direction, so I will right click on it and select the plus your button and click it once to rotate the light 90 degrees. Now that it's facing in the same direction as the other buttons on the control panel, we need to place it on the panel. So I'm going to drag it along to roughly the right horizontal position. Then while holding V for vertical down on my keyboard, I will drag the light upwards until white lines appear just above the nameplates of the 3 light buttons on the control panel. This indicates that the light is now at the correct height, so I'll let go. Now we also need to let go of the V key, then drag the light onto the control panel into position. We probably needed to zoom in before I tried to drag it, as you can sometimes pick up something else by mistake. It looks like I've got it anyway. So we'll drag it onto the panel. That looks like it. Now we'll let go. We'll just rotate the scene around a bit to make sure the light is indeed in position, and it all looks fine. Fantastic. Now let's select drivers and look at the list of actuators in factory I/O and see if the light is listed. Yes, it's there, light indicator red 1. Now we'll need to add it to the output side of the PLC, but as you can see, there are no spare outputs available, so we need to add another output to the PLC to allow us to do this. This is the great thing about factory I/O that I mentioned in a previous video, that a PLC with lots of physical I/O isn't needed because factory I/O uses virtual I/O, and therefore you can save money by purchasing a smaller PLC for development purposes. Right, now that I've finished my sales pitch, let's select configuration and add an extra output. Okay, now in the bool output counts field, type in 11 to replace 10. Already allocated. Once that's done, return to the driver screen and you will see output Q1.2 added. Now we just need to drag the light indicator red 1 actuator onto that output. There we go. Let's return to the main scene in factory I/O and go offline on the PLC to I/O portal. Now I'm going to open the tag list and enter the tag name, emergency stop activated. And I'll just amend that to start with O to denote an output. then enter. Now the data type and address have automatically been inserted, but we need to change them to bool for the data type and Q1.2 for the address. Great, let's go down to the main OB1 program. Before I do that, let's go to the device and enable the use of clock memory bytes. Where has that gone? I think it should be under General. Okay, let's scroll down a little, then select the box to enable them. Now we need to offset them because we are already using M0.0 to M0.7. So let's offset them by 20 and enter. Now you can see all the clock memory bits are readdressed from 20 onwards. Let's check that they have all gone into the default tag list. Yep, they have, so that's good. The one we will use is M20.3, which is the 2 Hz clock. Let's download the change in hardware configuration to the PLC. Download to device, then hardware configuration. Even just hardware takes time, so I'm going to speed it up a little. Okay, that's done. Now let's go back to the main OB1 program and enter code to flash the new red light on the control panel using the 2 Hz clock bit. So right at the very bottom of the outputs network, let's enter a new branch. Now there are two conditions for the light to flash on and off, and they are, firstly, M0.6, the emergency stop active, must be true, and secondly, the clock M20.3 must be in series with it, which then turns Q1.2, the indicator red light, on and off. So let's bring down a normally open contact and address it M0.6, emergency stop active, then enter. Then bring down another normally open contact and address it M20.3 for the 2 Hz clock. Now we need to add an output coil and address it Q1.2 for the indicator red light, then enter. Okay, we can now download the program to the PLC. We'll speed it up a little. That's done. Now we'll go online. I don't think we stopped the PLC running last time, so let's just make sure we are still connected on factory IO, then start factory IO running. So we are now ready to start the system running. Let's make sure we are in auto mode first, then press the green start button. We will just zoom in a bit and wait for a few pallets and boxes to start transferring. Now we will press the emergency stop button and see what happens. Straight away, everything stops and the red stop light comes on, and the indicator red light we added in factory IO starts flashing. So let's disengage the emergency stop, toggle the auto manual switch for the red indicator light stop flashing, then we should be able to press the reset button to zero the readout. Then press the green start button again to get the system running, which it does. We'll just press the emergency stop button again to see that we have the same result, which indeed we do. Let's just go into monitoring mode and see the 2 Hz clock flashing on and off while the red light on the panel does the same. Then we will just go through the steps again to stop the red indicator light flashing by disengaging the emergency stop and toggling the auto manual switch. Then we'll stop factory I/O. That's it for the panel function videos. Hope you enjoyed them. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. And please feel free to subscribe if you would like to see more videos like this in the future. Once again, thanks for watching and see you shortly.